Dear all, welcome to this complete tutorial on Microsoft Word. In just 13 minutes, you will see and learn all the main features to own this product very easily. Microsoft Word is the best word processor to realize documents, illustrations, and reports with the maximum control on page layout and text distribution. It is part of the Office bundle for both Windows and Mac OS, and it is available under either a subscription plan as Microsoft 365 or a perpetual license. You may also use Word Online for free, but its features may be limited in respect to what you're going to see in this video. When opening Word, its startup page opens with several options. You can reopen any existing document you have, or pick any ready template to start with a new one. To see how to use Word, let's start from a new blank document. This opens the main interface with the ribbon on top, with all the main tools within several tabs, and a big preview on the document page at the bottom. Use your mouse wheel to scroll up and down, and also hold down the Control or Option and Control on Mac to zoom in and out. To adjust the document properties, open the Layout tab to show the page setup section. With Margin, you can set the safe distance between text and page borders. With Orientation, you change the document orientation. And with Size, you pick a different standard and change the page size. Whereas use Columns to spread text across different columns, from the left to the right side of the page. As you type in, you fill the document page by following the insertion point. Other pages will be automatically added as you go on. You can also use the arrow keys to move the insertion point and type elsewhere. Whereas use Control or Command and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste text, especially if you need to import any large content. This is pasted where the insertion point is. Use Control or Command and Z to undo any action if you make any mistake. While you type, Word performs corrections and shows suggestions. For example, it turns the first letter uppercase when making a new line and shows tips when grammar, spelling, or punctuation may not be correct when you right-click on text. If you do not see these, make sure that the chosen language at the bottom is correct. To edit text, you have to select it first. Just click and drag on it as you need, or hold down the Shift key and move the insertion point character per character with the arrow keys. You can also double-click on any word to select it quickly, or click once from the left to select entire lines. At this point, you can edit text with a dialog box showing up, or the Home tab above, adjust font family, size, style, or drop subscript or superscript text, change the font color, add highlighting, or apply amazing effects, including outline, shadow, or reflection. Hover over these to get a quick preview before applying any. For all the complete options, open the font panel by clicking on the arrow in the bottom right corner. With the paragraphs, you can easily manage the text distribution. Every time you make a new line with the Enter key, you create a text paragraph, such as a collection of sentences that share the same topic and properties. You can show all of these by clicking on Show Hide under the Home tab. Each paragraph has its own alignment and distribution options. Click within the paragraph and go to Home, Paragraph to set its alignment. Choosing Justify to spread the words in order to cover the whole page width. With line spacing, adjust the distance between the paragraph lines as you need. Use shading to apply a custom background color to the whole paragraph and borders to add borders around it. Switch to the Layout tab to manage the paragraph indentation and spacing in respect to the previous or the following paragraph. You can also use the rulers to adjust spacing and indentation. If you do not see these, go to View and Enable Ruler. The horizontal and the vertical ruler measure your page width and height by taking the default measurement unit of your OS language. You can also change it by going to File, Options, Advanced, show measurement in units. Moreover, each ruler shows where text can spread in white color and the safe page margins in dark color on both sides. You can click and drag the edges to adjust these. Also, in case you have multiple columns, hold down the Alt or the Option key to check the distances between the ruler. The horizontal ruler is very useful to adjust indentation and distribution for the current paragraph. Drag the right marker to adjust the right indentation, and the left marker at the bottom to correct the left one. Hold down the Shift key to move all lines except the first one, and drag the upper marker to do vice versa. You can apply all of these adjustments to multiple paragraphs if you select all of these at once. You can create lists with the buttons under the Home tab. Click on Bullets to make a bulleted list with symbols, on Numbering to make numbered lists with ordered numbers or letters, and on Multi-Level to drop mixed lists. At this point, write the first line and go ahead with the second one with the Enter key, whereas use the Tab key to type on a lower level. With the Backspace key, you can return to an upper level or remove the current line. Click once on the list symbol or number to change it in color or style. In case of numbered lists, you can right-click and go to Set Numbering Value to either start from the beginning or continuing with the current list. You can also adjust the spacing of any list with the horizontal ruler on top, as we have seen for the standard paragraph. From the Insert tab, you can include several objects within your document. Click on Table to add any table with defined rows and columns, and click on any cell to type in. You can also open Table Design to adjust the table appearance, add background colors, or custom borders to the cells you have selected by clicking and dragging on these. Whereas switch to Layout to add or remove rows and columns. Split or merge selected cells and adjust text distribution on these. With Pictures, you can browse and import images and adjust these with Picture Format on top by correcting colors, adding borders, or applying any crop. Use shapes to drop polygons and arrows by clicking and dragging on the document. In particular, you can drop text boxes to import pieces of text completely independent from the rest of the document and contained within a rectangular shape. With the shape selected, you can open Shape Format to adjust the fill color, the outline color, and style, or apply any effect. Choose no fill or no outline to make these completely transparent. If shapes overlap, you can use the options inside Layout, Arrange, to adjust their order of visibility. You can click on any object to select it and drag it to move it, or use its nodes to resize or rotate it. This may change the text distribution on text boxes. When dealing with tables, use the left icon to move it and the right one at the bottom to resize it. When you select any object, you can click on Layout Options to set how this must be placed in respect to the document paragraphs. Choose Inline to put the object in line with the insertion point, or Text Wrapping to keep the object independent, with or without any distance from text. In this case, choose Move with Text to move the object as you add or remove text, or Fix Position to keep the object position fixed and independent from text. From Insert, you can also add equations and symbols where the insertion point is. Compose the equation with the options on top and drop any math symbol, Greek character or uncommon accents with the symbol panel. You can select equations and symbols to customize these in format, distribution, and style. You can drop headers and footers on top and at the bottom of each page. For example, you can add footers by double-clicking at the bottom. At this point, you can either type in or add pre-formatted footers from the tab on top, including document information or page numbers that increase automatically. double-click outside to apply. The color may be different only to separate the footer or header from the rest of the document. You can also add headings to separate large documents into useful chapters. Start with a new line or select any text on an independent line and go to Home, Styles. Select Heading 1 to drop the main title, Heading 2 for the first subtitle, and so on, adjusting format and style just like standard text. As you go on with a new line, you can type text, drop shapes, or include other headings. Then you can click on the arrow next to the main heading above to hide or show its content, making a very useful independent chapter. If you open the navigation panel from the bottom left corner, you can check all the chapters made and click on any to get directed where you need. You can also make numbered headings. Just type any number followed by a dot and add others as many as the heading level is lower. Word corrects these numbers automatically in case you change level or number on upper headings. With these same chapters, you can go to References, Table of Contents, to add a quick list of contents complete with titles and links. If anything changes, you can click on it and go to Update Table to get it updated. From the same tab, you can use Insert Footnote to add extra notes at the bottom of the page, right before the footer. Whereas with Insert Caption, you can include labels and a description to equations, figures, and tables. These come with numbers that increase automatically as you add more captions. You can adjust these as you like by going to Numbering. With cross-reference, you can add links to headings and footnotes, showing either their whole text description or just their number. To include hyperlinks, select any text and go to Insert, Link. Add any website address at the bottom, direct to any file you have, or select any heading within your document. Always test the link by holding down the Control or Command key and clicking on it, whereas right-click and go to Remove Hyperlink to delete it. To save your document, go to File and then to Save As, defining name and where to save it. Choose .docx to save all as a Word document in order to reopen and modify it later, whereas select .pdf to export it, to share it, or print it. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to catch our complete office guide to learn more with quick and easy steps.